So don't ever think that you're a nobody. You know what? God didn't create nobodies. It's very important that you get saved at a very young age and you follow the Lord Jesus Christ.
But God did not call us to quit. He did not call us to failure.
I can't even begin to describe the thankfulness of people like you that go out there and do the impossible because they know that they have a God who can do the impossible behind them.
Because I just think that just gets me orphans singing Orphans of God.
Changed my view on life coming here and seeing that I'm so spoiled.
Kids, if you guys follow their example, if you follow their step of faith,
this is the biggest blessing of all. To me, this is what the children's home is all about. When I came last year for the first time, I think about him. I think about him a lot. That someone else may consider not important or thrown away, and you show them love.
Challenge to me as well that I stay active not just in America but to have a heart that's open to the rest of the world as well.
This experience has been completely humbling and eye-opening for me. It's beautiful to see all the children and how appreciative they are of everything here. Just the simple things that they appreciate. They don't have electricity a lot of the times, yet they still have a lot of things that they do that they end up having fun with. And it's just so enlightening to see that people appreciate everything that they have rather than sitting here complaining about the things that they don't have. So this experience for me has just been completely humbling, and I wouldn't trade it for anything. It's changed my life completely. On our missions trip to the Philippines, we were able to run a very successful basketball clinic. We had around 73 children show up to the clinic, and we were able to show them a lot of drills and a lot of things to help them become better players. We also were able to spread the gospel to them and able to speak to them and preach to them for a little bit right before the clinic started. So we ended up reaching out to around 100 people overall, maybe a few more, but it was a very successful clinic overall.
Hi, Akabosi Courtney. I'm so glad that God gave me the opportunity to be a part of this missions team. God has been showing me many things while being here at the children's home. I watched the video for this missions team last year, and it just brought me to tears seeing how these children live. And they really don't have much, but they are just so happy and they're so humble and they have joy in their hearts and they're always smiling. God has been showing me that really you don't need things, you don't need material possessions to make you happy, but you really only need the love of Christ.
We had a really blessed time at the youth rally. God showed himself, and we did skits and games for the children. Over 100 of them showed up, and I even got the opportunity to preach. It was just amazing to see God move through the kids.
over 170 people from Arunkalpo City in the mountain and from the surrounding city who was able to get just some basic medical care. First off, we were able to share the gospel with them. And after that, we were able to just take care of their basic medical needs, whether it be just giving them Tylenol pain medications or just some cough syrup or cough drops. And it's just shocking to see how much of these people, there's no medical attention at all. And they just seek the most basic things. And it's just surprising to see that.
We were blessed with the opportunity to visit the local hospital and bring tracts and spread the gospel to these people that are very sick. As a nursing major, it was so shocking and heartbreaking to see how little they really have. I mean, the hospitals, they didn't have air conditioning or really proper medication or anything they really needed. But to see these people and their eyes light up when we come in the room and sing a song to them or show them the gospel, it was incredible.
We were blessed with the opportunity to visit a prison. This prison housed over 700 inmates that were boys and girls. We had Cody preach to them, and over 200 of them professed Christ as their Savior. That was truly a blessing. After that, we got to fellowship with them and even play some basketball. But of course, we didn't beat them too bad so that they'd still talk to us after.
It was the International Teachers Conference. This is the fourth year we've been able to be a part of this. And several of us gave sessions. We talked about routines and procedures for classroom management. Mrs. Ruffin gave some experiences from her 36 years of teaching. And then I spoke about the philosophy of some education. And we were so encouraged to see how many teachers came out and to be able to share the truths that we've learned, whether by experience or through the classrooms, and share that with these Filipino people and these teachers.
Each color on this bracelet depicts and symbolizes each part of salvation, starting from black, beginning with sin, ending with yellow, depicting heaven. And through this, he was able to understand and accept Jesus Christ into his heart. And now he knows 100% sure where he's going if his life were to end.
Piatas is the landfill where almost a million people live. And the only thing worse than their physical poverty is their spiritual poverty. This year, me and several of my teammates got the opportunity to do Bible lessons, help with the feeding ministry, and have a small medical clinic where we treated wounds and gave out medicine. For me, Piatas is probably one of my favorite parts of the Philippines because the trip shows how very real the need for help in the Philippines is. I like the fact that I get to help contribute to these people and just to be there for them and to help encourage them. Also, last year we did the Midnight Missions Run and we donated part of the money to the Tulabots here. Part of that money went to build an orphanage for the kids in Piatas. And this year I got to actually meet a couple of the kids and talk to them, and they just started going to the orphanage this year. So it was a really big blessing to be able to see these kids. And at church the other day, they sang for us, "Thank you for giving to the Lord." And it's incredible to think that if we hadn't have had that run, these children wouldn't have had the opportunity to be able to go to the orphanage and be able to get feeding and care and hear the gospel.
I thank God for Pensacola Christian College, Philippine for Christ Mission Team 2014 for being a blessing here in the Philippines.
Words cannot express our gratefulness for the sacrifices and generosity of each of the team members. Each one of them has been a blessing. Thank you so much. We look forward to seeing the next team.